welcome to the latest episode of NARC TV. You may well be watching this in the summer, but we are filming in the spring, winter, and it's cold. So without any further ado, we are currently at the Green Room at the Green Dragon Studios in Stockton, and we have a lovely performance for you today. Hopefully it'll warm us up.
Fingers crossed, because I'm starting to feel cold and it's getting dark. But anyway, before I do pass out, today we have figurehead of the Hartlepool music scene, charming purveyor of indie slacker rock and favourite of Mr. Tom Robinson of Six Music, and that is James Leonard Hewitson. Enjoy. We've got to go in again because it's getting cold.
Yeah. Material. How do you approach the kind of craft of songwriting? What's your sort of process?
It usually depends on like the core idea, like the first idea that the whole song derives from, and it really depends. Suppose sometimes it's just like a lyric, sometimes it's like maybe a bass line or something. It just has to be like one good idea. And then that, if it's strong enough, then I can usually get a whole song out of it. I don't know, like, Stable, so the two, so Stable, like that song that I've just put out and played for you there, that, I've had that lyric, I'm emotionally unavailable, I've had that lyric for a while, and I thought that would be an interesting basis to kind of like, work a song around. Structurally, I do kind of try and use like the conventional kind of verse, chorus, middle eight, double chorus kind of thing. But I deviate from that a lot too. I reference it a lot, but I deviate a lot from it as well. So the songs aren't always like on the nose kind of like pop structure, but you know, it's obviously heavily influenced by that.
So your songs have been described as anthems for the disenfranchised, which is quite a nice little tag, I think. Tell us a little bit more about the subject matter of the songs and what you tend to write about.
I do just kind of honestly kind of respond to like life and how I'm feeling and stuff like that, and I do put that into the songs and into the lyrics. I suppose, like, I don't know, like, I'll say like when you see a derelict building that like needs some work doing, and you like you sort of look at it and you feel a bit drawn to it. That's kind of like what it's like with lyrically. That's kind of like the same thing for me. Like that kind of world, and I don't know. It's kind of like that. I try to be honest, and like it's not. I don't know, it's not, none of it's too happy, none of it's like too sad, just maybe somewhere in the middle. And but then again, every song's kind of different and is influenced by different things, different experiences, social factors or whatever. I don't know, it just, I get what you mean though, it does all come out in a certain way.
Witty as well, aren't they? You've kind of got very much a turn of phrase that I think really identifies your songs, and you know, as soon as I hear it. So I mean, do you purposefully write kind of witty songs? Do you set out to write that way, or is it all about that subject matter, as you say?
I think like when I started writing songs, the lyrics and stuff, they had to kind of like interest me and like make me laugh a little bit, and that's why there's like plays on words, and it's more to keep me entertained than anything else. Because I mean, if you go on stage and you're singing something that you don't really like find interesting, then like, what are you doing?